So they say when a shooting star goes across the sky, makes a beautiful light and then fades and is never seen again, and it gives good value for the excitement of seeing it. Now, this guy was a shooting star, no pun intended, in the WHA. Almost hit the 50-goal mark in his first full season in Major League Hockey after being mired in the California Golden Seals system. But, again, just like a shooting star, we've been talking about these 1-, 2-, and 3-year wonders in the WHA, and this guy more than meets the match. The very talented Dell Hall comes from one of my favorite communities in Ontario, Peterborough. I've covered a lot of teams from Peterborough over the years, and let me tell you, there are some talented, talented people from that beautiful community. Now, he came to major prominence when, of all things, the very, very underrated Chatham Maroons of the WOJHL in 1970, where he scored 99 points in 40 games. He moved on to, of all squads, the St. Clair County Community College of the NCAA Division 3 in 71, putting up 53 points in 22 games. To my knowledge, there's not many Division 3 players in the NCAA eventually played in both major leagues. Now, 72, he found himself in the California Golden Seal program. He played with an affiliate in the IHL called the Columbus Golden Seals. 53 points in 64 games, including 26 goals. He had his first NHL game that year with no points. 73 with the Salt Lake Golden Eagles, the Seals' WHL affiliate. He had 42 points in 63 games, including 24 goals and 9 points in 9 playoff contests. Now, with California that year, he had six games with a call-up. 74 back to Salt Lake for the majority of the season. 79 points in 71 games, including 1 playoff game and 5 contests. But he did get his first NHL goals that year, ladies and gentlemen, with 2 in 2 games for California. Now, 75, mired in Salt Lake again. Sounds like a country song. Ended up with 32 goals and 30 assists for 64 points in 70 games in a regular season, and 15 points in 11 playoff games, including 7 goals. Now, people are thinking Hayes' career in Major League Hockey is done, but this is what happens, ladies and gentlemen. The Phoenix Roadrunners opened up to signing him, and he moved to the WHA and put up 2 of the best seasons ever in Phoenix Roadrunner history. 76 in his rookie campaign, ladies and gentlemen, 91 points in 80 games, 47 goals, 44 assists. And what's kind of bizarre that year, ladies and gentlemen, if you look at the raw statistics, you take 91 points, you would have won the team scoring race. Who did he finish second to? Robbie Fatorik, of all people. Fatorik had a great season that year, but he didn't win. But Dell had won the goal scoring that year. Second year with Phoenix, just as productive, even though he didn't play in the playoffs. Phoenix was knocked out. 38 goals, 41 assists for 79 points in 80 games. Now, he eventually started the 78 season with the Cincinnati Stingers, where he played 25 games before being traded to the Edmonton Oilers midseason. And he decided maybe that it was the end of his career. He did play one more game in the WHA with Edmonton before retiring. And that was the end of the shooting star of Dell Hall across the sky of the NHL and WHA. Now, what really helped Dell as well, a very, very typical left winger, 5'10", 175. And that was the type of player that could combine speed and accuracy on the wing. Now, final WHA totals, 177 points, including 89 goals in 186 games, 5 points in the playoffs, including 2 goals, and again, 2 goals with the Seals in 74. I still don't understand why they wouldn't give him a chance, because the California Golden Seals were lacking in offense. You know, give the guy a chance. Put him on a line with, Frank Sprague or something, the second or third line. Who knows with California, with with a certain owner, Charlie Finley, what he was looking for. But like I said, he can basically say that in the Phoenix Roadrunner history, he had one of the best complete seasons of any Phoenix Roadrunner player, and a very quiet and respectful player as well. In that first season with Phoenix, he never only took 10 minutes in penalties. which shows his dedication to the good side of the ice. So that's the legend of Del Hall. Thanks for listening. Give us a like, comment, or subscribe. We do appreciate you dropping in and requests and ways to shine the light on other 1, 2, and 3 year WHA wonders is more than welcome. Have a good day.